It can't be whitewashing if the story takes place with white Americans.
Boom! What's going on, crew?
Battle Angel Alita. Let's react. Wow.
Well, look at you.
May your dreams bring you in the darkness. May you
This is just a body. It's not bad or good.
Oh, she looks so good!
I don't mean to be rude, but am I supposed to know you?
Who's that lady?
Actually, we just met.
Harsh world. The strong prey on the weak down here.
The sun shines upon you again. Hear this prayer in my heart.
Does it bother you that I'm not completely human?
This looks good.
I'd do whatever I had to for you. I'd give you whatever I have. I'd give you my heart.
Alita, they will come for you. You are someone very special.
May you stay in the arms of the angel.
That's a cool song to go with it, too. All right, let's watch it again. Alright, for everyone that already knows about this, it's an adaptation. Over all the years and failed movies and disappointments and adaptations that I've ever seen, I've just come to the realization that the movie is never going to be as good as the book. Because movies aren't 8 hours long. And also, our brains and imagery and things that we create can't be created on screen the way you see it. Otherwise, if you don't like it, you go become the director. As for the whitewashing, there is none. That's what the characters are, and it's an ignorant argument that people have no clue about this manga is, and let's not pay attention to them. For everyone that has no idea what this story is about, it's about a cyborg that was found in a junkyard. She had her head and her torso. She's put back together by a cybernetic doctor. She's lost all of her memories, but one thing she does remember is Panzerkunst. It's a cybernetic martial arts. I recall there was 9 stories of this. As James Cameron said, this movie's going to take place over the course of like 1 through 4. So we are going to get Motorball, which is basically, if you've seen The Hunger Games or know what that's about, The Hunger Games was to take all the frustration and make people forget that they were poor and lived in like a dystopian future. That's basically what Motorball is. If they can pull it off, it's gonna look really, really cool. I don't want to get into too many spoilers with this. As for the CGI, I'm not really impressed. With Alita, yeah, absolutely. Her arms looked stunningly amazing. Face, like, I mean, it looked like sort of cartoony, but that worked. But there's a couple shots that I wasn't impressed with. The shots when she's flying through the air and it didn't look too good. For someone like James Cameron to be producing this, he actually wanted to direct this. Didn't have the time because he's working on the next couple Avatar movies. Yeah, that's right. Avatar is getting a couple sequels, guys. Last year, actually, he put Robert Rodriguez, who's done Sin City, by kids, like a couple like fun, crazy movies. He put him in charge. He talked to him. Like, they talked, and Robert Rodriguez had a good connection with the manga. They're trying to stay as true as they can to it. Like I said, it's not going to be perfect, but I'm just not impressed, Mr. Cameron. Like, the CGI, it doesn't come out till next year, so who knows? If anyone else wants to discuss this down below, like, maybe I'll make another video that goes in further with it. If you're interested and want that, smash the like button. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button. I do trailer reactions, reviews, movie Easter eggs, all that fun in the sun sort of thing. I'm gonna get back to my Jurassic World Easter egg video, which should be coming out later tonight. As always, I've been Tom. Laters.